and to this generation here. And I congratulate their master teachers. I congratulate their parents for bringing them and including them in this. It is such a beautiful sound. Your drumming is just amazing. So mahalo nui noa to all of you. Aloha mai kākou to everyone here. You just heard the wisdom and beauty of Sema Kaka, who is, we consider her our kumu here at CSL Kauai. She has been with us from the very beginning. She just represents Kauai. She is Mother Kauai to us. And I thank you today for bringing your blessing and your love and your beauty to us. Mahalo nui noa. So, I think we're ready for our opening song. The Sacred Earth Choir with Daniel Nelson will be singing, I Am Protected by Angels. Yes?
Yes.
And we are.
We are. Aloha.
Aloha.
You know that phrase, out of the mouths of babes?
Yeah.
How about out of the drumsticks of babes? Yeah. Does it feel good right here? So I'd love for you to sing with us as you pick up this chant. It's three different parts. It loops multiple times. And would you just echo these words back to me? If you can feel all the unseen beings that are here with us today. I am protected by angels.
I am protected by angels.
That's right.
That's right.
I am protected by my guides.
I am protected by my guides.
So thank you for looking out for me.
So thank you for looking out for me.
Thank you for looking out for me.
Thank you for looking out for me.
The second verse speaks about my intuition, and the third verse is I'm safe in the arms of the earth. So sing with us as you can.
Thank you.
moment to just really center right here and right now and really feel the vibration and energy of what has already occurred. Just take it all in, the love and the sharing and the beauty and the amazing talent and this just God that I call God showing up for each and every person that has come here, that has shared, that has served. There's this one presence, and it's seen and unseen. We are protected by angels at all times, seen and unseen, showing up in our life at all places, at all times, just when they're required to be there. And I feel that that day is today. I feel so many angels right here where I am. And I know that presence, that angel, that light, that love resonates between in each and every one of us, connecting us all together in that one force, that one power, that one thing that is love, that flows through each of us, that flows through this planet Earth, that flows through this island of Kauai, and makes it new in every single solitary moment. The water, the land, we, the trees, the flowers, the ocean, we are all one in that power, in that light, in that energy, making it new every single solitary moment. So I breathe into that, and to this day that we have come to celebrate all of it. This bold and daring adventure called life that we are on, and I say yes to it. I say yes, I'm ready for it, and I know each and every person in this room is ready for the bold and daring adventure of their own life. So if you are, just say yes with me.
Yes!
Yes.
Yes.
So let's let it flow. Yes. Let's let it flow. Let's let it go. And let's have an amazing time today and lift the consciousness of this great universe planet that we live on to a higher level just because we have come together today. That's what I know. I claim it, I announce it, I accept it, and I just let it be so as I say, and so
it is. Woo!
So how's everyone doing? If you're here for the first time, this is how I always dress. But let me just let you know about this. You know, I don't like to talk about myself, but when you get a beautiful gift, right, like this shirt that I'm wearing from China, from Rob and Roseanne, I say to myself, self, when are you going to wear it? And it's not my every Sunday type of thing. I thought, well, the next special occasion. Could it be any more special than honoring the bold and the daring and honoring all of you? So just in case you were wondering, it is very soft, I've been told. Thank you.
Okay, so if you're here for the very first time, this is a center for spiritual living where we practice just the universal truth of oneness, that we are all connected in the one spirit and the one life, and we just strive every day to live that life to its highest capacity within in us, in each of us, in our own individual way, and from that place, bring it out into the world, not by being affected by what's outside, but by from within, with a higher knowing of who and what we are, those divine beings and expressions of the divine creator that are just moving through this thing called life in the highest possible way. So welcome for joining us today. Thank you so much.
Yes, and I don't know when the proper time to stop saying Happy New Year is, but Happy New Year if we haven't seen you. It's a great, 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 great year. So who is here for the first time and is scared? No, who's here for the very first time? Raise your hand, please. Oh, wow. Yes, indeed, we have our journeyers here for the very first time. We call them the Bakersville Four over here because we know that that's where they're from. So if you are here for the first time, we'd like to let you know that we have some information about you that we'd like to share with everyone. I just want to make sure all the names and all the information is correct. Let's just let them know, right?
You are magnificent!
Did you know that? And the reason we know that about you is because we cannot know it about you without knowing it about ourselves. So let's say it all together, shall we?
I am magnificent!
And there's this guy standing on the table over there. And those are people that are off island who are going to be watching this whole thing today. So let's say aloha and that they are magnificent, shall we?
Aloha! You are
say something to the left of you or right to you, whoever's by you, let them know they're right next to you.
Jeremy and Amy Brown are here, a beautiful couple who sing for us at CSL Kauai on many occasions, and they are joining us today to give us their gifts of voice and their beautiful, 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 whatever else they choose to give us, I won't say. But we welcome them, and so let's just welcome Jeremy and Amy Brown.
Thank you.
Come on.
I watch Amy dance, I just get so moved by the love that she gives in the dance, in her hula. That is just so, just permeates your heart. Thank you so much. And when you sing, it's just love. That's what it is. That's what we're here about today and every day, is love. That's all everything is love. And if we can remember that, there is nothing too great for love. Love is everything. And love overcomes everything that we should ever, ever, ever come across in our lives. So we've named this year in our center the year of the bold and daring. Yeah, it's how many here feel like they live a bold and daring life?
Oh yeah.
We all live a bold and daring life. From the moment we were birthed onto this earth plane and chose to come here, which I believe we did, and we chose to come at this very time because we had a special gift to give. It's ours and only ours to give. We do this thing in our center a couple of times with our thumbprint and how each of us came endowed with an individual print. Nobody in this universe has what we have to give individually. And it's like a big puzzle, and each of us fits that puzzle in a unique way. And it's bold and daring to accept that sometimes, to accept that I'm that individual expression of the divine that was birthed here with a purpose. I might not know what my purpose is, but that's okay. My purpose is just being here and living my life to the fullest. And I love Helen Keller that wrote, and it's like a log line for our journey for the bold and daring, and I'm sure many of you are familiar with this quote, life is either a daring adventure or nothing. Life is either a daring adventure or nothing. Because if we're not living life to the fullest, being willing to live at our fullest capacity, and that is daring sometimes, especially when things get rough, then it's nothing. It's nothing. We're just existing. And we don't want to do that. We don't want to just exist. I don't want to just exist. I want to be fully living vibrantly with every fiber of my being, no matter what's going on in my life, no matter what I'm facing, no matter what. So one of the things that can help is having an intention for every day of your life. Getting up with an intention for good. Getting up and saying to yourself, I intend this day to be the best day of my life. I intend this day to be fantastic. I intend this day to be a healing day in my life. I intend this day to be a day where all my relationships are full and blossoming. I intend this day to be a day of full health for myself. When we set our intentions like that, nothing can stop us. So, one of the journeyers said to me, that they set the intention to come here, because sometimes it can be, you know, flying these days is not the easiest thing for any of us, that especially coming all the way, you know, 5,000 miles to get here and going on and off planes and all that stuff. But they set the intention that they would have a fantastic, amazing trip. There would be no shame involved in it. They would have a great time. And then things started to show up. Things like losing your luggage. Things like your plane being delayed, okay? And you go, oh, well, my intention didn't work. Well, how do you know? How do you know? If you say it didn't work, then it didn't work. But maybe that was just the thing you needed for something else to happen. And you wouldn't have known if that hadn't happened. So if you can breathe into when those things happen and be daring enough to say, you know what? I said this was gonna be the best day of my life. Or this was going to be a really fantastic trip here to Kauai, so what do I want to do now to celebrate that? Right? Doesn't it make sense? It makes sense to me. And it works. I can tell you it works, because once you set your intention out there, it has to show up. So my friend here, where are you? Reverend Jonathan Sands, our friend from CSL Toronto, who comes every year. This is his fourth year here. When he got here, we had something going on, a little challenging thing. And he just looked at us and said, well, I always say, get to work.